Ayo, welcome back everybody to another video, part of Game Raiders Week 3. We are here and we are testing out which Terraria wings, modded and non-modded, are the best, which ones can fly the highest, and we're going to be marking how high we fly with this sniper rifle. Thanks to the Weapons of Mass Decoration mod, we can fly up, and whenever we reach the highest point we think we can hit, boom, hit it with some paint. It might be a little bit inaccurate here and there, but oh well. If you want to know the real numbers, you know, for the wings, how high they can fly, check out the wikis for all the mods in Vanilla Terraria, and you will see the actual numbers. So how we're gonna do this is I picked out a couple wings from each mod and vanilla. You know, they all have a decent gap in between all of them, at least a 10 to 20 block radius. So we got Calamity as our last ones, we got the Miscellaneous one as our third to last, second we got Thorium, and of course first we're gonna test out vanilla. So we're gonna take off my Seraph tracers here, and we're gonna put on the Fin wings, which are pretty they fly pretty short. We'll see all of them. I won't talk about how high they fly, but just know I have them in an order where it's lowest to highest. So here we go, how high we can get with Fin wings. Here goes. Hopefully okay, right there. That's how high we got, was right there. So maybe I should change the color every single time. At this point, you may be like, Gamers, why aren't you testing all the sets of wings? It's mainly because they're not that big of a difference, and a lot of them are the same. For example, like 6-7 of them fly 77 blocks high. A couple of them fly only 72 blocks high. A bunch of them fly 67 blocks high. So I didn't want to test all of them because it would be pretty redundant and boring, because if it's like a 5-block difference, who the hell cares? So that's the main reason why I didn't test every single set of wings. Moving on to the next wings, we got the B wings. Now the B wings are the next best one, and let's see how high we can get with them. We're gonna mark this one with yellow, and obviously hopefully we should get a lot higher. Decent height right there. I might have shot like 1 block higher, but those are the B wings. Moving on to the next wings, we have Skiff's Paws. Now these are a dev set that you can get from a treasure bag randomly, but there's a couple other wings that had the exact same flight speed or flight height. So let's see how high this one gets us up. Come on. This one better be pretty high, like right there. A little bit higher than that, but obviously I didn't have a wall to shoot. But yeah, not bad at all. Moving on to the next one, the hoverboard. Now this is one of the cooler ones, and I picked this one out primarily because it is a cooler one. And let's just see it in action. But yeah, like I said, most of these, the paint shots aren't gonna be the most accurate. So if you wanna see the numbers, you know, hit up the wiki for the mods, hit up the Vanilla Terraria wiki, and you will see the exact numbers there. That one obviously higher than everything else so far. Moving on to the Stardust wings, which on the wiki said they were one of the best next to the other fire wings, whatever the hell the fire armor set, solar flare wings. So let's see, let's do it. This thing, I expect to go really high. Damn, it has insane vertical rise. So right there, not bad. That got us really far. Let's see on the mini map here. Let me zoom out. Look how fast we ascend, and look how long we can fly too. It's pretty good. So there you go. That was the Stardust wings and a majority of the vanilla wings. Like I said, a lot of them all have the same number, or a lot of them have, you know, such a small increase from the last set. It'll be like a 5-block increase compared to the last wing set. So that was vanilla. We're moving on to Thorium. All right, so the first wing from Thorium, you can get these pretty early on. These are pre-hard mode wings, so I don't expect them to send us that high at all. Champion wings, we should just, you know, just stop like right there. Yep, expected that from pre-hard mode wings. Moving on. All right, we are moving on to the Phonic wings. These wings are also a dev set wings. I think you get these just from treasure bags too. So let's put these on and we heading up. Let's see, I don't expect these to go too much higher, so we'll say right there, even though it's kind of more, yeah, that works. So we're starting to get into the more cooler looking wings, Demon Blood wings. They just sound cool too. So these ones I expect to send us pretty hard. These are hard mode wings. Actually, I think the Phonic wings might be hard mode too, but there you go, that one sent us pretty high. Moving on to the next wings, the Balladeer's Turbo Tuba. This is for the Bard set, and it is really cool looking wings. It's a tuba on my back, a turbo tuba, and this should send us really, really high, because this is a very late game armor or very late game wing set, and it sent us pretty damn high. I don't think anything has beaten the Stardust wings yet. The last wings from Thorium, Celestial Carrier. Now I'm hoping that this will easily beat the Stardust wings, but I'm not sure. We're about to see. Stardust wings were very high up here. It's like right under. We landed like right here. The Stardust wings were like right here. So a little bit less than the Stardust wings. I mean, given this is a healer flight set of wings, so I didn't expect too much from it. Moving on to our sort of misc set of wings here. Now we got some interesting ones that we're gonna look at here, but first let's start with the ones from Juice Mod, Roke /rock wings, however you pronounce it. These ones, pre-hard mode wings, don't expect to go too high. Oh, especially if I get stuck like that. Don't expect to go too high. Look at that. Did not expect to go high at all, but given they're pre-hard mode wings. But yeah, moving on here. We're getting to, you know, the more stronger wings. And this one has a whole paragraph I have to read, but I'm not going to read it. Flight Mastery Soul allows for very long-lasting flight. Now, it allows for very long-lasting flight. Does it allow for a lot of ascension? Long-lasting ascension? That's the real question we're about to see right here. I expect this one to easily beat Stardust and to just keep going. Oh my, this might be the best one we have so far. Oh my, it just keeps going. We might just end up in space. If this one keeps going, we're just gonna end up in space. Oh, I got stuck. Hopefully that didn't hinder the performance. I didn't expect to get stuck. Oh yeah, this one might just last infinitely. We're going to space, bro. Look, there's not much more of the map to go up with. Oh my god. Okay, so I think for sure, it might be too dark for you guys to see, I think for sure that these are one of the best wings, given that you do have to kind of combine like everything to make these wings. But yeah, not too bad at all. All right, so the thing with the next quote unquote set of wings, it says increases wing time by 200%. Now obviously we don't really need to increase the wing time of the Flight Mastery, so can I just equip this as wings in general? Oh my god, you can't fly with them. All right, so when's if I do this? It says increases wing time by 200%, right? Let's put on the Roke wings. So you can see the red spot left right there. Let's put these on and let's see how much higher we can fly. 200%, this is not bad. We are now moving on to the set of wings. Collection of wings is what I should say that everyone's looking forward to. Calamity. As you can see, we got a lot to go through here, but we've already seen the best wings in this mod pack that I have, and that was the, you know, the Flight Mastery. But we're not going to count those for now, all right? We still got everything else trying to compete here. Those ones, you know, they're pretty much end game. They're pretty much, you beat the game, you get those wings. But we're moving on here. Skyline wings, early set of wings that you can get in Calamity. And does anybody know where it went? Oh, there it is. Why the hell did it go into that slot? Here it goes. Ready? I don't expect it. Oh, here it goes. I don't expect to get too high. Early set of wings, look at that. It got like pretty much the same height as the rock wings. But moving on to the next set of wings, Hadarian, is that how you say it? This is, I think, another early game set of wings. I'm not actually sure, but I know it does not fly too high. So there you go, that was the Hadarian. Moving on, I think the rest of these are for sure hard mode and post moon lord plus wings. Discordian wings, these ones I think are pretty good. I know they're 100 plus maybe, or they might be 90. So yeah, not too bad for the Discordian wings. All right, so now we got another cooler one, much like the hoverboard, the Moab, the mother of all balloons. Now, this on the wiki said it had higher wing time, but I'm not 100% sure here. We're gonna see. The question is, how does this work? Okay, I see how it works. So let's do this. We're gonna try and do it at the peak of all our jumps. All right, not bad at all. Not bad, it did beat the Discordian. So that's actually really cool how this works. So it's just a bunch of jumps. It's pretty much what it is, which is really cool. It does say mother of all balloons, so you're pretty much using like balloon jumps, double jumps. Moving on to, oh, look at this, these ones look familiar. Serif tracers. Let's see how high these babies go. I expect them to do pretty good. You know, I use them all the time. People may ask why I don't use the best wings. Is because, you know, if I use anything higher than the tracers, I move really fast, and I don't really know if I want to move that fast. I like to keep it nice and slow, like even for bosses sometimes, like the Spirit of Purity, for example. I put Seraph tracers on. Actually, do we even have the better tracers by then? I'm not sure, but I usually switch to Seraph tracers because they're a little bit slower. Sometimes I'll even switch to like Frost Spark. All right, I think we're about to get into like the 200s and the 300s with the next like three, or the last three, Tarragon wings. They're really, really good. They're really good. But yeah, like I said, make sure you guys check out the wiki if you want the exact numbers, because obviously I'm not going to be the most consistent here in terms of, you know, hitting these paintball shots. That one I shot extremely high. Let me try again. Try and keep my mouse still. Boom. That was kind of perfect. You got to give me that one. All right, so these last two I expect to be the greatest. These, from what I remember on the wiki, were 300 plus. So let's start with the Celestial Tracers. Boom. Put these on my feet. Beautiful wings on our back. Let's do it. I'm ready. Don't get stuck on anything. I'm going to try my best to line up a shot here too, but I don't expect to hit a shot for a while. Oh, boom. All right, a little bit higher than that, but that's pretty close. So those got us pretty high. That got us almost quarter plus. Yeah, I don't expect any wings to get us halfway because we are on a medium world, I think. This might be a large world. Nah, it's a medium world. But yeah, those were not too bad. Moving on to our last and final set of wings here. Drew's wings. It's a Revengeance drop. You know it's gonna be good. So this one was like 368, maybe like near 400. So I expect these things to pretty much send us nearly halfway, because if the other one sent us almost a quarter plus, this one should send us nearly halfway. So let's sit right here. nearly halfway. Like I said, I think halfway you would have to be like 600 wing time, which is an absurd amount of wing time. But yeah, it seems like our best set of wings was obviously flight mastery set. But to make the flight mastery set, let me just show you guys the recipe for that. It does require a decent bit of farming for all the stuff you need here. But it's not too bad, given that there's only like two, no, not even two, maybe a little bit more than that. There's a handful of modded wings in there, but it's really good. It's really good. And you know, honestly, the calamity ones might be a little bit harder to get, but you know, Fargo's mod is low-key a cheat mod once you get in the end game. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope this gave you some knowledge, because you know, there were some mods in here, and if you want to figure them out in detail, like I said, hit up the wiki. They got the exact numbers if you want to be efficient and have the best possible. Hit up the wikis. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys are enjoying GameRaiders week 3. I love you guys. Make sure to hit the like and the sub button, and I will see y'all in the next video. Love you. No homo, full homo, whatever you want it to be. Hey, don't forget to subscribe to my new YouTube channel, where I'll be posting all of my Twitch live streams on. Link will be in the description.